Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hello, everybody. Thank you so much. Welcome to Tattletales. It is nice to have you with us today. I have to tell you that sometimes I come out, more often than not, I will get a kiss from the person who hands me the microphone, and today I'm kind of glad I didn't. But I'm glad you're here. Thank you, sir, very much. Come over there. I'll be there in a moment. First of all, I would like to welcome you all here, and I know you're going to have fun today because we have some people who have been with us before. They're with us again, and you're lucky. Here they are. Winning money for the blue section today, the star of SWAT, Mr. Steve Forrest and his wife, Chris.
Yeah.
There you both are. Welcome back. Been a long time.
Thank you very much.
In fact,
much,
I think the last time you were here, Steve, the show had just come on the air or was about to come on the air. Am I correct?
We weren't on the air yet.
You
we were
about
doing
to.
Them.
That's right.
Right.
Well, anyway.
I feel a little weird today without my megaphone.
Yes, I understand that. We
you
should
got
play,
any hostages, throw
we
down
should
your
play your theme
your
song, too. That song is driving me crazy. I love it, though. It's a great tune. Chris, how are you, love?
I'm just great.
You all set to go?
I sure am.
Here we go. Winning money today for the banana section. It's been too long since he's been with us, and we are glad they are back. Mr. Steve Allen and his wife, Jane Meadows.
I'm very happy. Very happy to be sitting next to the star of SWAT, because I'm the star of a new series called Snit. Somebody just gets angry.
Oh, is that, I was going to ask you what it was about. It's a person who can't control his...
Gets into a snip.
I thank you, sir. Jane?
Yes, dear.
Nice to have you
it's
with us.
It's nice to be back, and I want my yellow team out there to hold a good thought. We're going to win today.
Okay.
Keep your fingers crossed.
You certainly know how to soothe the savage banana crowd, don't you? Winning money today for the Red Sections, first time on our show, also an old friend, Mr. Tom Poston and his wife, Kay. And I should say, lest we forget, of course, one of the stars of On the Rocks, and it's terrific, and congratulations to you. And you look, I haven't seen you since New York, I guess, huh?
I was a teenager.
Yeah. And my mommy brought me here that day. Kay, how are you, darling?
Oh, just fine.
You're going to have a good time today, I promise you, okay?
Oh, thank you. I hope so.
Yes, you are. Here comes the first question worth $150. This is it, ladies. It's for you. Ladies, do you think that women fall in love more easily than men do? Yes or no? Good question. Ooh. Off you go. Think that one over, and we'll find out. Steve, what will Chris say to that? Do you think that women fall in love more easily than men? Yes or no?
We're trying to say what she's going to say to it.
Mm-hmm. I'm asking what her the question. Really, so.
You're asking her the question. This lady, who ought to know, is going to say that women fall in love much more easily than men.
Really? Do you think that's true? Is that?
Do I think it's true?
Yes.
No, I don't. We're in clear disagreement about it. You're asking me what I think she'll say.
That's right.
Right. She's going to say that women fall in love much more easily.
That's
than
the way
men.
To play the game. She'll say yes. Here she comes now. Chris, do you think that women do fall in love more easily than men? Yes or no?
Yes, I do.
That's right. That's what he said. Why do you think so, Chris?
Well, I think because women are a little bit more gullible than men.
Oh. Really? Oh, that's interesting. I don't agree. Do you agree? I think it's an interesting subject we've opened up here. You have a share of the pot anyway for the blues.
It's a question of faith.
Yeah, I don't think Steve agrees with you either. Steve, what will Jane say?
I think Jane will say no to this.
Wait a minute.
I lost your banana.
And I also say to the people in the yellow section, because it's my wife, and I know what I'm talking about. You know what I mean? You dirty rat. Of course, I could be right.
Yes, of course, you could be. But how do you feel about it? Do you think that that's the case?
I think men are, if gullibility is at issue here, I think men are probably bigger pushovers than women. Uh-huh. So I think men fall in love a little more readily.
Yes, okay. And we'll see. And you're going to say that she will say no. They do not. The women do not fall in love more easily.
Yes. I mean, that's what I'm going to say with my mouth.
No, yeah. She's
going
to say no, though.
She's going to say... What's the question again? Yeah. No.
Funny, I feel like more the opposite absurd whatever. All of a sudden. The answer is no. Here she comes. Jane, do you think that women fall in love more easily than men do? Yes or no?
Oh, yes.
No, that's not what Steve said.
Protect him, Steve.
I see by that look that you're slightly incredulous there.
I am shocked. I'll tell you why, because I'm the romantic of all romantics, and I fell madly in love with Steve when I first met him, and I had to work so hard to win him. And then everybody I know all through history, women are romantic. They fall very easily.
Mm-hmm.
Men flirt and fool around, but they don't fall in... they don't really fall in love like women do.
Yes, and with that word
question.
Of wisdom, we'll move right on.
Dear.
Flirt and fool around. There's a good title in there, I think.
I think I'll write a song.
I think so.
Fool around too easily.
Yes.
La, da, 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 da.
Sorry about that, Jane. Tom, okay, say.
Don't, Steve. Don't. Now, cut that out. Well, I think that, yes, put your hands up there, wherever. I think that Kay will say that women fall in love much more. Now, I happen to agree. I mean, I think that way, too, because the guys I know that are not too sure of what they are, they fall in love all the time. And I think that...
I don't think that's on my card here, Tom. We're not really...
It's everywhere else.
It's on the
I air. Think that Kay will say that women probably fall in love more easily than men.
Okay. She'll say yes.
What do you think?
Here she comes now.
And if she doesn't, I'll get her at home.
Okay. Kay, do you think that women fall in love more easily than men do? Yes or no?
It's worded that way. I was going to say, this is my answer. You tell me what it is. That women do all those nice things so that men will fall in love with them.
So then your answer is that you do not think that women fall in love more easily than men?
No.
That's not what Tom said. Tricky devil, isn't he? Tom has a look of surprise on his face. And Chris and Steve got all the money for the blue section. And we'll come back in a moment with question number two. You surprise us, folks. Stick around. Who falls in love more easily? I'll tell the truth. This is number two, and this is it. And if you are ready, ladies, Jane, you and Kay have to catch up with Chris. She's got all the money at the moment.
We will.
We'll read this as soon as I turn it over. Ladies.
Yes.
It's your anniversary, and the two of you are going out to dinner.
Yes.
You have your choice of two restaurants.
Yes.
One has romantic atmosphere, but the food is only so-so. The other has terrific food, but has absolutely no atmosphere.
Oh.
Where would you go for your anniversary dinner? Think that one over. Off you go. Good question, but I think what makes it a little stronger is the anniversary part of it. What do you think, Steve? What will Jane say?
I believe Jane will opt, because she's one of the great operators, as you know, for the romantic restaurant.
She will.
Yeah.
The heck with the food. Just for fun, if it was not an anniversary, would that be the answer?
I think she probably would most of the time.
Really?
Assuming the food wasn't atrocious, you know.
Yeah, it's just so-so. Okay, but you're going to say that she will say she'll go for the one that has, you know what I mean.
The romantic atmosphere.
But the food is only so-so.
Yeah.
Okay, here she comes. Jane, it's your anniversary, and you and Steve are going out to dinner. And which one of those restaurants are you going to take? The one with the romantic atmosphere but so-so food, or terrible atmosphere but great food?
Well, I just told you on the last one what I am. I'm a romantic.
So?
So, naturally, I'd take the romantic restaurant, and if we're wrong, it's grounds for the...
You're right. You're not wrong. You're absolutely right. Now, Bonanza. Thank you, Jane. Tom, what will Kay do?
I think Kay will want to go to the romantic restaurant and drink.
And the heck with the food, huh?
Who cares?
Who cares about the food? Right, that's what I was going to say. We should have put that on the card. It would have been a cinch, wouldn't it? You'll say the romantic restaurant. Here she comes. Kay, which one of those restaurants are you going to go to? It's your anniversary. One is romantic with so-so food. The other is absolutely no atmosphere, but good food.
Give me romanticism.
That's it. You got it. Well, that was easy.
Girl.
Absolutely correct. Okay, money bags. What are you going to do, Steve?
Money bags.
What will Chris say?
Yeah, well, she very definitely is going, this is anniversary. This makes it very easy,
yeah.
This particular.
And probably
I think
that
so.
Out.
Yeah, I think you would have gotten some confusion there because she's going to say the romantic restaurant.
She is.
Then the next day we'll talk about how great the food probably was at the place that had no...
Where we didn't go.
Right.
Okay, here she comes.
She's going to say the romantic.
The romantic one. Here she comes. Chris, which one will it be now? Anniversary, two of you going to dinner. The romantic restaurant with so-so food, or the an atmosphere-less restaurant with great food?
Bert, this is going to be an easy one. I don't like food that much, and I'm a very romantic person, so I'd opt for the most romantic.
You got it. Well, you all got that. That was easy. We'll split that three ways, ladies, and we'll change places. Gentlemen, step to the rear, if you will. We shall bring the ladies out front. We shall return with the second half. Don't go away. See you in a moment. Hello. We have changed places after halftime. I have three lovely ladies with me. Gentlemen, if you are prepared, here is the first question, or the first one, worth $150. Men, which would make you feel worse? If you caught your wife having an affair, or if she caught you having an affair?
Oh.
Oh, my goodness. Goodbye, fellas, you silly gooses. Off they go, the little devils. And Kay, you seem to react to this question rather strongly. What do you think Tom will say to this?
I think that's a Fifth Amendment question.
Oh, yeah.
We kind of thought so, too. It's probably why we asked him.
Wait a minute. If he caught me or if I caught him, mm-hmm. Is that the question?
Yes, which would
basically?
Make, which would make him feel worse?
I think if he caught me, he'll
think
never
so.
Catch me.
Oh. But he never will, eh? Okay.
Caught me, yes, he's a chauvinist.
Now, that's a good angle on it. I never thought of that. Make him feel worse if he caught you.
Absolutely.
All right, here he comes. Tom, which would make you feel worse, if you caught Kay having an affair or if she caught you having one?
That's too easy to answer. It would make me feel much worse if I caught her having an affair.
That's it. You got it.
I rethought that, though.
Ooh. It wouldn't bother me. It wouldn't bother me at all if I had an affair. I would like it.
No. No, the question, Tom, was if she caught you having an affair.
Yes.
You wouldn't like that too much. So,
Kate, oh, no, I wouldn't like that at all.
No, you wouldn't like that at all, so don't you get caught. Okay, Chris, what will Steve say?
That is a hard one. Hmm. Repeat the question.
Okay. Which would make you, Steve, I'm asking, feel worse, if you caught your wife having an affair or if she caught you having an affair? What would make him feel worse?
I think if he caught me having an affair.
Think so, huh?
I do.
That would make him feel worse. Funny, all the guys up there went, yeah. All right, if he caught you is what you'll say. Here he comes. Steve, which would make you feel worse, sir? If you caught Chris having an affair or if she caught you having an affair?
What would make me feel worse?
That's right.
If she caught me having an affair.
No, that's not what she said. That probably would make you feel worse. You probably wouldn't live through it either.
Gee.
Sorry about that.
We forgot to read Open Marriage.
Steve. Well, it works both ways, obviously. It can go either
way. I cramped for this show, Bert, but I'm sorry.
Yeah. Jane, what about
Steve? Bert, I just hate this question.
Yes.
Because
yeah.
It is very difficult. I just have to go into Steve's mind. Now, I got to tell you a minute. First of all, I think he will say, if I caught him having an affair, because he assumes right away, he knows that he would not catch me having an affair.
Oh.
So he won't even think that way.
Why does he assume that? Are you that clever?
Naughty.
I'm sorry.
But listen, if it was you, it might be different.
Whoa.
But no. Just erase that, please. He can't hear it anyway. No, I think that he assumes he knows that I love him very much and that... As Tom said before, it's the insecure person that fiddles around. So I think Steve knows that I wouldn't do it, so he would think in terms of, oh, dear God, what would I do if Jane caught me? Because I think he loves me enough.
Okay.
That's a long answer, but that's what I think.
No, but it's a good answer.
No, but remember, Steve.
The bananas are grumbling.
You've got to put yourself in Steve's shoes.
That's right. And they're really big ones, too. He's a big guy. Okay,
you want me to change? It's your money. No. Please, on this one, go with...
Okay.
I think so.
He'll feel worse if you caught him.
Yeah, I think so.
Right, okay, here he comes. Steve, which would make you feel worse, if Jane caught you having an affair or if you caught her having an affair?
Oh, this is one of those questions like, would you rather hit your mother or your sister on the head with a hammer?
That's right.
Both alternatives are spooky. Of the two painful alternatives, I would think it would be, I would feel worse if it was a matter of Jane having the affair.
Oh.
No, that's not what Jane said. She would feel worse, she says, you would feel worse if she caught you.
Ah.
Interesting, huh, Jane? Shame,
man. Well, I'll tell you one thing.
What will you tell us,
Steve? I'm sorry, Yellow Team, but that shows he loves me more.
Yes, right. You come out winners of bananas.
Oh, that's
lots
terrible.
Of luck on that one. Kay and Tom get the whole bloody thing, gang. And we have two-thirds of a tie. Anybody can still win. The $300 question coming up after this message. Don't go away. See you in a moment.
Want a schedule buzzer? Celebrate National Game Show Day with us and get a chance to win. Go to BuzzerTV.com and click to vote for your favorite schedule. You'll be entered into our drawing where you could win $1,000 or some authentic vintage prizes. Your chance to win is just clicks away. On Buzzer, let's play.
All right, we're doing nicely. We have a tie. Well, two-thirds of a tie. Tom and Steve are tied with $200. Steve Forrest, that is. Jane and Steve, you still can catch him.
Don't rub it in.
No, you can catch him. People have come from $50 many times.
You're incompatible. Face it.
Here's the question. So men, this is worth $300. Ooh. Think of the one person in the world you dislike the most. Picture yourself marooned on our famous desert island alone with this person for a year.
Oh, my God.
At the end of the year, do you think you'd be better friends or worse enemies?
I'd like to hear this again.
It's a good question. Think it over, fellas. We'll come back to you in a moment.
They are.
Off they go. I guess what we're talking about is he conciliatory? Is he that kind of person who would somehow find a shining light in adversity? And we'll start with Jane. What will Steve say?
Oh, you start with me.
Yes, I was trying to stall there for a moment.
Knowing Steve, who is a very, very peaceful, kind, loving, easygoing person, I don't think he hates anybody that much, frankly, to start with. I think he would, he's very civilized. He would get along better with a person.
He'd be a better friend than a worse enemy.
He'd work out some way of getting around, you know.
Okay, all right. The bananas like that.
Thank you.
They are with you all the way. Here he comes now. Well, I assume you've thought of that one person that that you dislike the most, Steve. Now you're on that island for a year with him or her. Do you think you'd be better friends at the end of that year or worse enemies?
I never thought about the her part of it.
Aha. Uh-huh. I said person, yes.
Yeah, that's true. Anyway, I would think definitely we would be better friends.
That's it. You're right. Well, now you have a share of the $300. At this moment, you've got the whole $300. However, we've got two more people to answer the question yet. All right, here we go. And we'll start with you, Chris. What will Steve say to this?
Bert, I kind of think that this is male or female talking about.
Oh, yes. The word
male
is person.
Or female. If you really dislike them and he had to stay on that island for a year, I think, because basically he doesn't really hate anybody that much, I think that he would, he'd end up getting along with them.
Being a better friend.
Yes, I think so.
Oh, okay.
So.
I thought sure you were going to say the other thing. I really thought you were going to say he'd be a worse enemy.
There was a lot of suspense there.
Yeah. Right, that was good.
Okay, but it's going to be better friends.
Better friends.
Here he comes. All right, Steve, what do you think now? A year on the island with the person you dislike most in all the world, will you be better friends or worse enemies at the end of the year?
Since the person that I particularly am talking about happens to be a female, I'd say we'd be better friends.
That's it. We got it.
A hell of a lot better.
You see, there's always a...
Oh, that's good.
See, there's always an interesting twist to these questions.
Terrific question.
You think about the, you can think up the enemy you want and then enjoy yourself.
Right.
Thank you, Steve. This will decide the game, Kay. What will Tom say?
Oh, I know exactly who he's going to think about.
Oh, who is it?
I'm not telling.
Give us initials.
Oh, no.
Give us the first name.
KP.
KP.
No.
I used to peel his potatoes a lot.
I never liked those initials.
KP.
Those are my initials.
Oh. I thought we had a real scoop.
No. I don't think you could survive just the two of you alone on an island without being friends. And I'm hoping that's what Tom's going to say.
Better
He's very generous. I mean, his soul and his spirit is. But I know this person that he doesn't like.
and you're having a tough time with it, aren't you?
It's going to be tough. they're going to be friends.
They're going to be better friends.
I think so.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean...
That's if they didn't kill each other in the first month, right?
Exactly, exactly.
Okay, here he comes. Tom, have you got that one person in the world that you really dislike the most? You're on that island with that person?
Sure.
After a year with that person, are you going to be better friends or worse enemies, and this will decide the game?
Sorry. No.
No, no. We would either be better friends or Don Knotts would be picking coconuts out of his ears.
You would be better friends, and you're right. You're all right. We split it three ways. Guess what? We have a tie. The Blues and the Reds have done it. We shall return momentarily to give the Blues and the Reds all their money. Don't go away. See you in a moment. Blues and the Red won $300. We had $1,000. Their sections will divide 1,600 big ones. Congratulations. We'll see you all next time on Tattletales. Thank you all for tuning in. Bert Conley saying so long, everybody. Bye.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.